Минасан, коничива. Today we review Sega Mega CD game Cyborg 009, which is based on very popular and old manga and anime series of the same name, which spans from black and white 1968 TV series and followed by anime in 70s, which was a bit strange, after it in 2000s, which is best version in my opinion, and if you want to get in this series, start with it. And finally, even most recent one, which was released in 2016, but in 3D now, and design of characters just horrible in it, and story too, do not recommend it to anyone. Series was created by Syotaro Ishinomori, who also made Kamen Rider and Super Sentai series, so it is thanks to him we have Power Rangers now, and Cyborg 009 was basically a foundation for them. In it we follow story of 9 people, who were turned into cyborgs against their will by military organization called Black Ghost, which wants to start another world war. But with the help of Professor Gilmore, we escaped from them and started to fight back, ruining plans of Black Ghost for world domination in the process. To do that, cyborgs have various powers, which are unique to every member of the team. 001, Ivan Whiskey, little baby from Russia, but has great psychic powers, can use telepathy and move objects with his will. 002, Jet Link, has a jet thrusters into his feet, so he can fly faster than any plane, and so on. 009, Joe Shimamura, main character of the story, and have best abilities from them all. Besides super strength and great durability, he can use Kasoku Sochi, which slows down time and allows him to travel at unbelievable speed. But Black Ghost also has many powerful cyborgs at its disposal, so this fight will never end. Sega CD game repeats all major plot points of the original story. You will meet Elena, which was used by Black Ghost to get your trust and capture one of your friends. You also will fight with Grease Guards, who are cyborgs and were created by Black Ghost. And you will fight with Skull too, general of Black Ghost army, and even will meet the real leaders too. All of this presented in very nicely done animated cutscenes, which are fully voiced, and it is very interesting to watch them and follow its story. But if you want, you can turn them off in the option menu and play all levels without any interruptions, because these cutscenes can be pretty long. But game itself a bit average run and gun game of that time. You can play only as 009, and will see all the cyborgs only in cutscenes between levels. You can run, jump and use your blaster gun as attack weapon. You can upgrade its power by collecting special balls and levels, which are sometimes hidden. And these power-ups helps a lot, especially on bosses. You also can use Joe's special ability, Kasoku Sochi, with which you can dash in any direction and jump much higher. It is used pretty often to reach some platforms or to evade enemies' attacks, and can be performed just by pressing or holding C button on the controller. Levels too, nothing special, but they look varied and different from each other. In some you will go from left to right, in others from bottom to top, and few will be forward-scrolling levels. And they have few secrets in them too, but levels overall very short and simple. Even enemies in them do not pose any threat to you, even on hard difficulty, because they are not endless, and once you will destroy them, they will never appear again. But to my surprise, if you will see too many enemies on one screen, FPS will drop a lot, and game will go into slowdown mode, which is very disappointing. This is especially noticing in Grease level, when with every centaur on the screen you will feel it, but after they will disappear, everything will return back to normal. Bosses too, even if they look interesting, very easy to defeat. The attack pattern very simple, and you can touch the attacks with ease. Only boss which can pose any threat, last one, and only because it is too small to hit him, and he shoots in every direction too. But at least game has one pretty unique boss fight, where you can use only your fist. But it is too not challenging at all, once you will figure out his pattern. And to my disappointment, this game very easy and short. You can beat it on your first try in around 1 hour, on hard. And this is with long cutscenes between levels. Without them, I think you can beat it in less than 20 minutes. And game doesn't have any replayability too. If you watch the original cartoon and know these heroes, you will like this game, as I loved it. Because it has many great little touches, like opening and closing songs from the first black and white anime about them. And it is great to see this story again, with touching ending. But if you do not know anything about this series, I doubt you will think many good things about this game. It is too easy and short, and even has slowdowns at times. So it was made only for anime fans. Other people can skip it. Minasan, konnichiwa! Today I will review Super Famicom game which also was based on Cyber 009 anime. But unlike Sega CD game, it isn't following anime story and created brand new villain for it, Scientist Geese, who turned himself into computer data and can control over robots and machines. So Professor Gilmo and Cybers need to stop him once and for all. Game still action platformer, but a bit more complicated than Sega CD version. For starters, you can choose to play as any cyborg besides 001. We all have different stats, like attack power, defense power and such. And before each mission you can create team from 3 cyborgs, their leader will be predefined by the game. You can switch between them at any moment in the game, by pressing left or right shoulder buttons. But they all share life and special meters. Your character can run, jump and jump from walls too, but it isn't very intuitive. To do that, you need to press D-pad in the direction of new jump, which is hard to do, it isn't Mega Man X. You can shoot with blaster, but its reach very short, so it isn't very good. And you also can execute 2 special moves, which are unique to each cyborg. 009, for example, can slow down time and run faster. 002 can fly around the level. 004 can shoot a rocket from his knee, which can do a lot of damage to enemies, and so on. But such special abilities use SP meter, but it restores automatically over time, and with some character it does this faster than with others. You also can use such abilities to help explore level more, like 003 ability, to see better in dark caves, or see map of the level, or 005, to break rocks and progress footer, or 008, to swim underwater, because all the cyborgs getting damage in it. Each mission divided in few sub-levels, in which you can find access to another sub-level. But it doesn't really matter which path you will take, because in the end you will reach same boss. But you will want to explore levels fully, to collect icons with experience points, which you can use after level will end, to raise stats of selected character. So you can spend a lot of time in levels while searching for XP, even if levels not so big. But few levels can be confusing, because they are some sort of maze with different doors. Even so, if you will ignore experience icons, you can finish all missions pretty quickly, and game has only 5 of them. You will visit different countries, but you hardly will tear them apart, because they all look the same. Only Antarctica level looks different, because it is mostly underwater level. And at the end of each level you will fight with a boss, but they are nothing special too. The attacks pattern very primitive and many bosses have safe spots too, so they are super easy. But main problem with bosses, their health bar, it is too big and you will need to hit them a lot of times. Even if you know what to do, this can be very tiring. Last boss especially boring because of that. You can stay in one spot whole fight, so he can't hit you. But because he cannot be in any random place, whole fight becomes a waiting game. Graphics are very subpar, you can hardly tell this is Super Famicom game, because it has so little colors. Even Sega CD game looked much better. And in addition to that, game also have some heavy slowdowns, when few effects appear on the screen. So yeah, this game is a real mess. Even if you can play as almost any cyborg and use the abilities, and I like 007 ability the most, because he can fly, but unlike 002, he controls much better, and his hitbox much smaller, so you can easily dodge enemies and explore level. Gameplay in this game not the best. Exploration mostly pointless, because all you can find experience points, and all different exits still lead to the same next sub-level, just in different parts of it. Game also very short, and story almost non-existent, even if you will see some dialogues before and after each mission. Plus, this game was based on 70s anime, and I know this because 007 has purple skin color. Yes, 70s anime was strange. But do not even let me start on 60s anime. It was even stranger. It was different times indeed. So I expected to see Odin and all the cyber gods, or even new black ghost leaders. But got generic villain instead, and bosses which you will forget after you will defeat them. Yes, you will fight with Hermes, but even he looks horrible here. No comparison to Sega CD game 2. So you can check out this game if you're a Cyber 009 fan, or even if never heard about this anime. But do not expect much from this game. It is very subpar, even if it has few unique ideas, like different special abilities of each character. Technical problems, boring bosses, mediocre visuals and forgettable levels can be overlooked. Minasan, konnichiwa! Today we review PlayStation 1 game, which also was based on Cyber 009 anime. Simple character 2000 series, volume 15, Cyber 009, the Blue Kuzuchi. Why such strange name, you will ask? Well, this game from a series of budget and very simple PlayStation 1 games, which started with simple 1500 series, and 1500 was in the title because this game cost same amount of yen. And later we added different branding to these games, so Simple Character 2000 was born, and Cyber 009 The Blue Kuzuchi one of such games. It is based on the Blue Kuzuchi video game, which is also not original and just very simple arcanoid clone with few new things in it. But at least Cyber 009 license gave this game a bit of personality. At the start you have few options to choose from: story mode, score attack and gallery. Score attack pretty simple, you just play in it until your first death and trying to get a new high score. But story mode a bit more interesting. In it you can choose from 8 different cybers to play as, and 001 you will need to unlock. Each cyber have different stats, like ball speed, paddle size and so on. They all also have different special ability. This mod also has very primitive story, how Professor Gilmour discovered strange block over some cities and called cybers for help. So now you need to travel around the world, gather all the cybers and discover who was behind it all. Of course it was Black Ghost again. In the game you can move paddle from left to right and need to break all blocks in the level. You also can shake screen to change speed or direction of the ball, which is useful at times. And you can give energy to a ball, accelerating it in the process. But you can do it only when ball hits your paddle, and at times it will change color, which means he can go through any blocks with this. Blocks can be destroyed with one or more hits. Indestructible blocks also exist, which obstruct path of your ball. And at times it is very irritating, when only one block left and you can't hit it at all, because of indestructible blocks and not very good ball physics. I am not arcanoid expert, but it felt off at times, and ball always goes to the left from the paddle at default, which is very bad. But to clear all blocks easier, your characters have special attacks, which you can use if you will fill combo meta at 100%. You can do it by breaking chains of blocks without hitting anything else, and such attacks very useful. 009, for example, can multiply ball, 002 can clear top row of blocks, 007 can make his paddle even bigger, and 008 can create platforms which will save your ball from falling off the screen. But levels themselves very bland, they all look the same, only background picture changes and music too. And at times you will see not all level, but only part of it, around your ball, which is nice addition to the game, but used that fully only in the last level. And by beating story mode, you will open picture of cybers with who you played, which is questionable reward, but it is something. And if you will beat story mode with everyone, you will open Ivan Whiskey, and I must tell you, he is only for hardcore arcanoid fans. His paddle very small and ball speed just insane, so you can lose all lives pretty quickly with him, but at least his special ability makes up for it, because it can clear all the remaining blocks in the level. But to fill special meta to use it will be a real challenge. So this is it, nothing more to this game. I said to you, it was a budget title. And even Cyber 009 branding not helped it much. Even as Arkanoid game it isn't good, because ball physics not the best, and besides special abilities and kinetic ball shot, you won't see any other power ups. But this game has over 750 different levels, so you can play it for a long time if you want. But who will do it? And so, this was the last Cyber 009 game on home consoles. After it, it was released only on pachinko machines, and patchy slot machines too, which is big disappointment. At least Konami added one song based on this franchise to the arcade rhythm game, Poppin' Music. I hope someday we will see new Cyber 009 game on current consoles. It can be very good. This is all. See you in my next review. Do not forget to like and comment. Matane!